17. 17 stars sat upon the horizon, each sparkling in its own unique way. Some were huge, others quite small, but together they shone as bright as day. Set upon their own revolutionary motions, they knew one day they'll eventually part. But a night will not be wasted on such thoughts, as tonight their questful journeys start. Steadfast and shining brightly, all working diligently in a ritualistic dance. Some will travel far, others quite near, but each will have an equal chance. This quest for distinction will be a difficult one, but hungry for greatness, they'll never cede. With focus, precision, and constancy, they are 17 stars destined to succeed.
Assalamu alaikum, my dear parents and students. It is indeed a pleasure for me, as principal of Fiber vs. Islamia TIA, to bring a message to the graduating students of the Standard 5 class, SEA 2021. Behind me is a beautiful background done by class teacher Mr. Ishraful Ali Aziz and Mrs. Hafiza Ali Kerry. And if I look at the words inscribed there, "We are virtually awesome" is the theme selected by the children of this class, and it's very, very poignant when I think about its meaning. These children are down in the school's history book as being the first set of students to complete their SEA class in total virtually. And I have to give them credit when credit is due. After the global pandemic occurred in our country and schools were shut down, these children were asked to stay at home and do their SEA class with their teacher virtually. And by force, they were instructed to adjust and acclimatize themselves with the use of digital devices to get their learning. And I have to say, alhamdulillah, I have seen some of their work over the months, and I must say, credit is due to their parents, teachers and the students themselves, because they would have excelled beyond my expectations. Now students, as you await your results, and as you get your results for the SEA, this was an act of God. It is what it is. Where you are, use this opportunity of the last 7 years at Fiber vs. Islamia TIA to be a stepping stone for you to move on, to move forward, to seek and conquer into the world. And the greatest advantage you have as a feather in your cap is you are indeed virtually awesome. That is a strong belief in my heart. I have witnessed that for myself. For myself, first time, your ability to navigate and to go with the flow. As you enter Form 1 in your secondary school life, there will be more of the virtual challenges. Please take your time, take your schooling seriously. All the life lessons you would have learned at Fiber vs. Islamia TIA, take them with you. Get involved in your school student council movement. Take part in community activities and do what you can to build a better society in Trinidad and Tobago. On behalf of all of the teachers at your school, on behalf of the ancillary staff, on behalf of the BOA, on behalf of every other stakeholder involved in Fiber vs. TIA, we want to wish you God's blessing, God's speed, good luck and success in all your future endeavors. I love you. I will miss you. Assalamu alaikum.
can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. I'm taking. Sometimes I knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah, just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on.
Seriously, I would punish misbehaving children by giving them lies. I wrote lines on 25 occasions throughout my time in both of Ms. Fadia's classes. Now, there's my standard one teacher, Mrs. Asha Hussain. Three words to describe her are kind, caring, and patient. She is one of the most patient teachers in the school, who taught us several disciplines. Unfortunately, her stay with us was curtailed due to her pregnancy, but she definitely left a lasting expression on us. After graduating Standard 2, I grew to be afraid of the Standard 3 teacher, Mrs. Sabra Sabrati. Some said she was the scariest and strictest teacher in the school. Others said she spit fire when scolding children. However, as I entered her classroom, she was the complete opposite. She's a very caring and kind-hearted teacher. In fact, on the last day in her class, she made us cupcakes. She encouraged us to revise for upcoming exams by stating that she would reward the first and second place winners with a rabbit. I came first place after writing the end of term exam and won a rabbit. And yes, he's still alive. Mrs. Zuhra is an amazing teacher. Finally, there's Mr. Instrumpal Ali Isaacs, my standard 4 and 5 teacher, one of the loudest and funniest teachers I had. He's a very hardworking and determined teacher who would go all the way for his students to ensure that we were all prepared for the SCA exam. It was in his class where I found my passion for creative writing. Without the guidance of these teachers, our journey towards the mountain peak would never have been as memorable as it was. Thank you all immensely. Of course, none of this would have been able without the without the stern guidance of our dear principal, Mrs. Salika Muhammad Ali, who was there to ensure that our journey was safe and on course. We also must not forget Mrs. Hafiza, Mrs. Sahida, Mrs. Farisha, Mrs. Fazia, and all the amazing OJTs who were there to help us up to the steep slope from time to time. We also need to thank the parents who supported us through thick and thin. They held our hands and believed in us, believed that we would make it up the mountain if we tried hard enough. They never gave up on us, even when success seemed non-existent. If it wasn't for them, how would we be able to sit on a mountain peak and enjoy the breathtaking view that we enjoy today? How would we even exist without them? They cared about you so much to the point that they reminded you about being home. It's the little things they do in life that make the biggest impacts. They bought you stationery and expensive books. They were the ones that paid for your uniforms and even bought you luxury items and praised you. We should be proud, proud that we have parents. Thank you, parents, for not only being there when the trail to the mountain was rocky, but also showering us in endless support. We love you. Although we didn't get to enjoy the last moments in this school together physically due to the COVID pandemic, we should still be proud. We made history. We were the first class to attend our standard 4 and 5 classes during the pandemic via virtual learning. We never even got to sit in the standard 5 classroom until our SCA exam. My fellow graduates, we are strong. We were strong enough to actually keep sanity during a pandemic. However, we still got to see each other virtually. That's why the theme of this graduation is, we are virtually awesome. Now, online learning wasn't as enjoyable as going to school in my opinion, but we still covered lots of topics and even learned new things about the internet. I came from a unique class with many different personalities. Actually, I recall a student from my class once stopped doing his work to catch an iguana, then proceeded to display the iguana he caught. I also recall quarreling with my teacher over a science quiz that I thought occurred, but didn't actually happen. There was also a time when Mr. Aziz made jokes about a student's dog named Jet. Jet was like the class's mascot. I remember some of the terrible excuses excuses that children created to get out of exercising. One of the students even pretend they were exercising when they were actually hiding under their desk. Many hilarious incidents occurred during the classes that I won't ever forget. These will stay in my mind permanently. I recall one of the teachers saying, "It doesn't matter what school a child passed for, because wherever they go, they will succeed." As we stand on the pinnacle of the mountain, we realize that we are well poised and ready to embark on a new journey. We gaze as far as the horizon, knowing that we have a golden future ahead of us. Some of us may stand confidently, whereas others may shudder in fear while gazing at the seven mountain peaks in life, each bearing a gift. I'm glad to say this, that we are surely more experienced at climbing these mountains, these mountain peaks of knowledge, because of the time we spent at the Five Rivers Islamia TIA Primary School. We may have thought that our journey had ended when we reached the top of the first pinnacle. My friends, I am sorry to tell you, but you all are dreadfully wrong. For this journey of knowledge has only just begun. But, just so everyone knows, we, the graduating class of 2021, have definitely tested positive for success. Thank you.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. The struggles I'm facing.